came into a place of worship, a place of praise. The Holy Ghost had arrested each group of soldiers and had them praising God. So when they came to take David out, glory to God, each group came praying to the Holy Ghost. The first group came and they got arrested. The second group came and they got arrested. The third group came and they got arrested. Then Saul came to Saul, and the Bible says that the Holy Ghost stripped Saul. He laid out naked, and glory prophesied unto God, which means he praised God. Don't you understand? Your problems will get arrested when you bring them to God. Your problems can get turned over when you bring them to God. Your problems become, glory to God, they become powerless in the presence of God. Glory to God. It doesn't matter what you're going through today. It doesn't matter who said what about you, what they said against you. But you just have to trust and lean on God. You just have to come and give it to God. One great thing about the problems is that your problems will chase you to God. Your problems will chase you to an anointing. Your problems will chase you to a breakthrough. Your problems are designed, glory to God. Sometimes we can be in a place of comfort, and we get locked and we get slapped the days ago. But sometimes God want to chase you out of there. So I'm going to let fire, I'm going to let the smoke happen, I'm going to let situations happen, because I want to bring you somewhere. I want to take you to another place. Bring me your problems and I'll solve them. God wants you to come out. Glory to God. God wants us to come higher. It shouldn't have to take it, but sometimes it does. Sometimes God has to chase us. Allow the enemy to go crazy in our life so we don't forget about the house of God. When we've been out of church for too long, situations happen, and God got to let the devil bring you back to church. Glory to God. Sometimes even in family, glory to God, situations have happened because God will let everything around you crumble just so you can remember him. That's the part of the process, the strategy that God's going to do. That's all right what they say. It's all right what Sennacherib speak. Let Sennacherib talk. Let the enemies talk. Because God's going to speak a word over your circumstance. God's going to cause it to turn around. He's going to cause the situations to go back to where they came. He's going to send it back to the sender. Glory to God. God wants to deliver his people. God wants to bring you to a greater place. But God also wants you to praise him for it. Your praise is going to release something. Your praise is going to break down the walls of the obstacles. Praise is going to destroy the enemy. Your praise is going to break down his strategy, the fortress, the foothold. Hallelujah, God. But God wants you to praise him. See, when you're still on your praise, you're still on your breakthrough. When you're still on your praise, you're still on your strength. I'm reminded, glory to God, in Matthew 21:16, when the children were praising God because Jesus was healing the lame and the blind. Glory to God. And Jesus was healing them, and the children caught glimpse of it. I believe the Holy Ghost had rested on them. And they were saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. And the Bible says that the Pharisees and scribes got upset about it. Do you hear what they're saying? And Jesus said, yeah. Have you not heard out of the mouth of babes, thou hast ordained praise. Thou hast perfected praise. You got to understand your praise is perfecting you. It's perfecting the strength of God in your life for what you can't do. Your praise is going to cause God to show up and perform in you. So what you wait for? Why sit on God? Why make God have to call you out just to praise him? There's a praise in you that's ready to release your blessing. There's a praise in you that's ready to cause your high places to come down. There's a praise in you that's connected to your breakout. There's a praise in you that's connected to your promises, connected to your prophecy. There's a praise in you that's going to cause the places my God. Somebody give God some praise. Ah, glory to God. 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 The house of the Lord. The house of the Lord. See, this is why it's so important to come to church. Because when you come to the house of God, you have a chance to break out. You have a chance to break free from what you've been dealing with. Even if you've been dealing, oh God, with addiction, you've been dealing with problems. But I can make it to the house of God because this is the place of destination, the place of destiny. If I can just get to the house of God, if I can just get to the place where God is, if I can get, oh, glory to God, around the other believers, where the praises of God is being circulated, where the breakthrough of God is being ushered, glory to God, if I can just get in the water to pull us along, if I can step in the spiritual water, I can be made whole. If I can get to the pool, I can. If I can dip my leg in, if I can let it run up to my knee, glory to God, if the water can wash over me, if the anointing of God, if it's in the building, I can get my hearing, I can get my breakthrough. I ain't got to settle for this. I don't have to stay in this predicament. I don't have to stay this way, but I can get healed and set free in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. In the house of God. In the house of God. Psalms 27:4. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek, that I might dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret place of the tabernacle. He shall hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. If I can get to the house of God, then God will hide me in a pavilion. If I can get to the place of God, then God will hide me in a secret place. Then God can work on me. Then God can move on me. Then God can speak life through that step in. Then God can speak and confirm the things that I've been believing and trusting. Then God can speak. Oh God, and water the seed and give seed. Glory to God, and cause me to, amen, to become rich on the inside. So when I go back to my situation, when I go back home and I go back to work, I'm not the same as when I left. Because my inside, bow, glory to God. Because the inside now, as to what's going to come out now, is glory. What's going to come out now is praise. What's going to come out now is hope. What's going to come out now is belief. Glory to God. And when these things come up, they don't defile a man. Oh, glory to God. But they begin to set that person up. Glory to God. Because when I come to the house of God, and I learn that I don't have to be this way no more, I don't have to be that way no more. But now the preacher said that I can be set free and I can bring my problems to God. And so now when I go back home, I can tell my circumstance, I'm not going to take this no more. But now I speak the blessings of God. I can speak the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding. I can speak to my situations and speak life like Ezekiel did when he spoke to the dry bones and said, live. I can now speak. My situation's got to live. My circumstances got to change. Because I left my problem at the altar. I left my problem at the feet of Jesus. And when I left it there, I came back home with praise. I came back home running free. Just free. The best free. Lord, so God, I got a new talk. I got a new look. I got a new hope. A new expectation now. Because what God did, God did it. God ain't doing for you. Can God do it? I need to redeem to say so. I need to redeem to say so. Can God do it for you? Can he do it before? Ain't the man do it again? Can God do it? The answer is yes. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Whom he has redeemed from the hand of the enemy. God is going to do it again. But God wants you to praise him. So that them that don't believe, don't stop believing. Thank you. nation, reach their household. Glory to God. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of our God. Glory to God. Bless the name of our God. When we come to God, know we have the Holy Ghost, and he who searches the heart knows the mind of the Spirit. It's because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Glory to God. Now we have the Holy Ghost, and now he intercedes on your behalf. So now, like Hezekiah sent word to the prophet Hezekiah, oh God, pray for your people. Pray for the remnant that's left. Now we have the Holy Ghost. Holy Spirit, what are you saying? What's the situation here? What's your report? I heard what the doctor said, but now what's going to be my outcome? Which way should I go? Should I consider? Oh, glory to God. So am I going to be set free? Am I coming out of this or what? And when God lets you know the word of God, that you shall be delivered. I've seen what the doctor said. I've seen what's going on in the body. I've seen how the cell's been acting. I've seen how the lung's been acting. I've seen what the heart is doing. And now I speak to the heart. I speak to the heart. And command the heart to be healed. I speak to the heart. Glory to God. I take the word of God and apply it to my life. I take God's word that you were bruised for your iniquities. It was bruised so that you could be healed. The transgression, glory to God. What God did, he healed you back on Calvary. What Jesus did, with every whiplash, with every beating, every strike, was a strike so you could be healed. A strike so you could be set free. What's already was done, redemption took place. Redemption is not just for what you came out of, but what you might get caught up in the future. He redeemed you from the hand of the enemy. Redemption is showing up to cover you in your household. Redemption is redeeming power to repurchase, to buy back, to take back from the devil. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Bless him. Bless the Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Bring me all your problems and I will solve them. Bring me all your problems and I will solve them. Glory to God. Bring me all your problems and I will solve them. I don't know who you are here today and what you really need. But there's a word in the house. And as long as there's a word, you can receive the blessing from the word. If there wasn't a word, then you might not be able to receive it like this. But if there is a word, you can come out and raise your faith level and embrace and accept what God wants and that is offering you today. If you're here today, glory to God, and you need God to bless you. You need God to work out some circumstances in your life. I urge you to come down now. I need you to come down now. Glory to God. You know if you need something. You know if you need God to fix it. And don't get it twisted. Some of us know we just need to give our lives to the Lord and it's going to work itself out. Some things are chasing you to God. And the longer you just, come on, come on, come on, church. Come on, come on, come on. Some of you in here, what are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Haven't you seen God? Haven't you seen the goodness of God? Why stay there and die? Why stay in that place and dry out? Why stay in that place and go without? Glory to God. But God is calling you to another place. God wants to call you to the place of righteousness, a place of sustainment. Glory to God. God wants to save you in here today. Who are you? Who are you? Will you come out today? Will you give your soul and your heart to Jesus Christ? Will you give your heart and soul to Jesus Christ? Will you come out? This is the day of salvation. This is the day. This is a call for you. Hallelujah. It's not just to feel good when I come to church, but it's to have an impact. It's to cause me to change. Who are you today? Who are you today? Who are you? You can meet me here down at the altar. This is what salvation means, deliverance. It's deliverance because it's saving power, saving grace, saving power. Come on, y'all, give me your attention. Give me your attention. Let's not talk while the sermon's on. Let's not talk in church. Don't miss what God is saying. Don't miss what the Lord is saying. We can get so wrapped up in conversation and playing with one another, that we totally miss what Jesus is trying to say. It's a bad thing to be in the house of God, amen, and God is saying something that can save your soul, and you missed it because you're talking and conversing. Let's not do that. Amen. Let's have more order and respect for God's house. But if you're here today, come on out. Come on out. Glory to God. Why stay there? When inside of you, the seed is saying, let's go to God now. Let's go to God now. Jesus is ready. Are you? Is there anybody in here today you saved, but you're scared to come? I'm just shy. I'm scared. I don't want to be the only one. Just slip your hands up. I will come preach it, but I don't want to be the only one up there looking silly. If that's you, come out. Just slip your hand up. Just slip your hand up. If that's you, if you're not saved, come on out this time. Glory to God. Amen. And if that's, amen. If anybody coming for salvation, amen. If there's anybody coming, amen, and you want God to work on the circumstance and the situation that you're in, then come. Glory to God. Sometimes we don't even need folk to pray for us or lay hands. We just have to ask God and praise. Amen. Sometimes. Amen. Amen. Anybody else? Glory to God. Glory to God. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, God. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Y'all brothers, just line up over here. Let's just talk.